mother is pushing for justice for her only son, who was shot to death 5 months ago.
Fox Files investigator Chris Hayes just acquired 911 call records that raise more questions about what really happened.
Jamie Coley and her husband Charles Barnett met with prosecutors last month about the shooting death of their son, 24-year-old Rico DeMond Coley.
It's hurtful. It's painful that they're not doing anything.
The couple says Belle Fountain neighbors police ruled Rico's death an accident. Barnett and Coley found video appearing to show what happened right after he was shot. July 28, 2019, surveillance video from a nearby home shows Rico Coley sprinting out of the house where he had been shot. The 24-year-old collapses in the street. A woman follows 44 seconds later. You see her walk around him in the street. 30 seconds later, the recording shows the woman walking to a car, Rico following behind. Next, you see the woman runs back to the house. Then she returns and goes through the car about a minute. As the video runs out, you can see the trunk open, the passenger door open, the woman just standing by the car until, see that movement on the passenger side? The woman runs around to Rico, who's out of view. He's bleeding from being shot in the shoulder. The video stops with no sign they're leaving and no sign of an ambulance at 3 minutes and 43 seconds. Jamie not only wonders why the young woman did not appear to rush into the hospital, she wonders why her son was not able to get through to 911.
The 911 call was dropped 6 times. Why would you drop the phone 6 times calling 911 unless someone is trying to tell you shot me? And you're hanging up the phones.
911 records confirm Rico's phone called 6 times and that, quote, the caller hung up after a sign to dispatcher. It's noted all 6 times between 11:08 and 11:09 a.m. Records also show dispatchers called back 7 times. That's a total of 13 failed 911 attempted connections. Police call records show officers were dispatched at 11:11 anyway, here to where it happened on Norwich Drive and Belle Fountain Neighbors. But it appears the woman had already left with Rico. They went to Christian Northeast Hospital, less than 3 miles away. But Jamie says it was too late. Shelby Cooper used to be roommates with Rico and the woman.
She could have got him there and he could still be here today.
Cooper thinks the shooting should be considered a crime.
They're not looking into everything. They're not checking it. They're just going by her saying it was an accident.
Jamie says she found the video, not police. She says she's also learned of video cameras inside the home that may have recorded the shooting. She's pleading with police to get that video. We tracked the woman seen on camera with Rico that day to where she's now living in St. Francis County. A relative answered the door. He told me to mind my own business. Jamie Coley wants the woman to answer to authorities.
I don't approve that she should be walking around enjoying holidays with her family and my son is not here with me.
Jamie and her husband met with St. Louis County Prosecutor Wesley Bell and an assistant prosecutor who said they are investigating. We should have an update soon. For the Fox Files, I'm Chris Hayes.